Welcome to Adult Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a big challenge. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Lost Key of Rome. Unveiling the Colosseum's Hidden Chamber. Chapter 1. The Unforeseen Discovery. David Thompson, an Englishman with a zest for history and adventure, stepped onto the cobblestone streets of Rome, his heart brimming with anticipation. Rome, a city steeped in history, had always been on his list of places to explore. As an amateur historian, the allure of walking through the remnants of an ancient empire was irresistible. His first destination was the Colosseum, Rome's iconic amphitheater, a colossal testament to the grandeur of the Roman Empire. David walked through its massive arches with a sense of awe, touching the weathered stones that had witnessed centuries of history. He imagined the roars of the crowd and the valor of the gladiators that once filled the arena. As he explored the less frequented corridors of the Colosseum, away from the throngs of tourists, David's attention was drawn to the ground by a glint of metal. Half buried in the dirt and grime was a small, rusted key. It was ornate, its handle intricately designed with symbols that hinted at its Roman origin. Intrigued by this unexpected find, David carefully unearthed the key. It felt surprisingly heavy in his hand, its cold metal a silent witness to a long-forgotten past. The key's design was unlike any he had seen in modern locks. It was an artifact in itself, perhaps a remnant of the Colosseum's ancient history. David's mind raced with questions. What door did this key open? Was it a mere decorative piece, or did it once serve a greater purpose? The possibility that the key could be a part of the Colosseum's untold history excited him. He knew he had stumbled upon something extraordinary, a piece of the puzzle in understanding the vast tapestry of Rome's past. Unable to contain his curiosity, David decided to seek expert opinion. His search led him to the local university, where he met Professor Bianchi, an esteemed historian specializing in Roman antiquities. The professor, a slender man with a mop of white hair and sharp, inquisitive eyes, listened intently as David recounted his discovery. Upon examining the key, Professor Bianchi's face lit up with a mixture of surprise and intrigue. He explained that the key closely resembled those used in ancient Roman times, specifically in structures like the Colosseum. What was truly remarkable, he noted, was the design on the handle. It bore a striking resemblance to symbols associated with the Roman deity Janus, the god of doors, gates, and transitions. Professor Bianchi shared a legend about a secret chamber within the Colosseum, long considered a myth by historians. The chamber, according to legend, was said to house relics and manuscripts dating back to the zenith of the Roman Empire. If the key were indeed connected to this chamber, its discovery could be groundbreaking. The possibility of uncovering a hidden chamber within the Colosseum captivated David. It was the kind of adventure he had always dreamed of, a chance to touch a part of history that had remained hidden for centuries. Buoyed by Professor Bianchi's enthusiasm and expertise, David proposed that they undertake an expedition to find the chamber. The professor, with a glint of adventure in his eyes, readily agreed. They planned to explore the lesser-known parts of the Colosseum, areas where the public seldom ventured. Over the next few days, David and Professor Bianchi prepared for their exploratory journey. They pored over old blueprints and documents of the Colosseum, tracing the architectural changes it had undergone over the centuries. Their research revealed a network of underground passages and rooms, many of which had been sealed off or forgotten over time. Equipped with flashlights, maps, and the key, they set out to unravel the mystery. The Colosseum, with its vast corridors and hidden recesses, was a labyrinth waiting to be navigated. They delved into the depths of the ancient structure, walking through corridors that echoed with the whispers of the past. Their search was methodical, guided by the blueprints and a shared sense of anticipation. They examined every nook and cranny, every wall and doorway, looking for a lock that matched the key. The exploration took them deeper into the Colosseum, into parts that had succumbed to time, where the air was thick with the mustiness of history. As they ventured further, they came across faded murals depicting scenes of Roman life, remnants of intricate mosaics, and even fragments of weaponry and armor. Each discovery was a piece of the grand narrative of the Colosseum, a testament to its multifaceted role in Roman society. The deeper they went, the more David felt the weight of history around him. The Colosseum was more than just an architectural marvel. It was a portal to another time, a place where one could almost hear the echoes of cheering crowds, the clash of gladiator swords, and the roars of wild beasts. The corridors grew narrower and the air cooler as they descended into the bowels of the Colosseum. Here, away from the eyes of the world, the true scale of the amphitheater's history began to unfold. They passed through underground chambers where gladiators once prepared for battle and cages that once held ferocious animals. Finally, in a remote and almost forgotten part of the Colosseum, hidden behind a wall of ancient brick and mortar, they found it, a lock that matched the key's design perfectly. It was set in a heavy wooden door, its wood aged but still strong, the lock covered in dust and cobwebs, untouched for what seemed like millennia. With a mix of excitement and reverence, David inserted the key into the lock. It fit perfectly. As he turned the key, there was a loud click, and the door creaked open, revealing darkness within. They stepped inside, their flashlights piercing the gloom. The chamber was small and circular, its walls lined with shelves that held scrolls, pottery, and various artifacts. In the center stood a stone pedestal, on which lay a collection of manuscripts and items that appeared to be personal belongings of significant historical figures. David and Professor Bianchi were awestruck. The chamber was a time capsule, preserving relics that provided a glimpse into the everyday lives of those who had been part of the Colosseum's history. There were scrolls that contained accounts of battles, ledgers documenting the amphitheater's management, and personal letters that shed light on the human aspect of the ancient spectacle. the discovery was monumental. It was a historian's treasure, offering new insights and perspectives on the Roman Empire. For David, the experience was transformative. He had begun his journey as a tourist, driven by a simple curiosity about the past. But standing in the hidden chamber, he realized he had become part of something much larger, a living link to history. David and Professor Bianchi emerged from the Colosseum with a sense of accomplishment and responsibility. They knew that their discovery would attract global attention and that they had a duty to preserve and study these relics with the respect they deserved. As they stepped back into the Roman sunlight, leaving the shadows of the past behind, David reflected on his journey. He had found more than just a key. He had unlocked a door to the past, revealing stories that had been silent for centuries. In his hands, he held not just a rusted piece of metal, but a key to understanding the complexities and wonders of human history. Chapter 2: The Key's Secret. After their astonishing discovery in the Colosseum, David and Professor Bianchi dedicated themselves to uncovering the key's origins and the secrets of the hidden chamber. The professor, with his extensive knowledge of Roman history, suggested that the key might date back to the Flavian dynasty, a period known for its architectural marvels, including the Colosseum itself. Their research led them to the archives of the Vatican, where ancient texts and artifacts were preserved. Amidst the age-old manuscripts, they stumbled upon a faded scroll with a depiction that mirrored the design of the key. The scroll told of a Roman architect, Lucius Gallus, known for his innovative designs and secretive nature. It mentioned a special chamber he constructed within the Colosseum, intended to safeguard knowledge and treasures that were deemed too precious or dangerous for the outside world. The revelation that the chamber was designed by Lucius Gallus added layers of intrigue to their discovery. It suggested that the contents of the chamber were of significant importance, perhaps containing knowledge or items that offered insight into the lesser-known aspects of Roman society. Energized by this information, David and Professor Bianchi returned to the chamber with a team of historians and archaeologists. They began a meticulous examination of its contents. The chamber, untouched by time, was a historian's paradise. Each scroll, artifact, and relic provided a snapshot of Rome's glory days. Among the discoveries was a collection of personal diaries belonging to various historical figures, including senators, military commanders, and even a gladiator. These diaries offered a rare glimpse into the daily lives and inner thoughts of those who lived during the height of the Roman Empire. Perhaps the most intriguing find was a set of architectural blueprints signed by Lucius Gallus himself. These blueprints outlined designs for parts of the Colosseum that were never constructed. They depicted elaborate mechanisms and traps, suggesting that the Colosseum could have had a more complex and multifaceted purpose than previously thought. As they delved deeper into the chamber's treasures, David and the team discovered a series of maps depicting trade routes and conquests, some of which contradicted existing historical understanding. These maps hinted at the vast and far-reaching influence of the Roman Empire, some even suggesting voyages to lands unknown in other historical records. The chamber also held a collection of artifacts from various cultures that had interacted with Rome, including Greek, Egyptian, and even distant Asian civilizations. These items ranged from simple household goods to exquisite pieces of art, illustrating the diversity and richness of cultural exchanges during Roman times. The examination of the chamber's contents took weeks, with each item carefully cataloged and preserved. David, initially an outsider to this world, found himself increasingly drawn into the intricate tapestry of historical intrigue. He began to assist in the preservation process, learning the meticulous methods of handling and conserving ancient artifacts. The more time he spent in the chamber, the more David realized the key had not just unlocked a hidden room, it had opened a portal to understanding the complexities of human history. The chamber was a bridge connecting the present to a past that was more vibrant and interconnected than he had ever imagined. Professor Bianchi, seeing David's growing passion for history, began to mentor him. Under the professor's guidance, David learned not just about Roman history, but about the art of piecing together stories from remnants of the past. He discovered the delicate balance between preservation and exploration, understanding that each artifact was a piece of a larger historical puzzle. Their work in the chamber started to attract attention from the academic world. Historians and archaeologists from around the globe came to study its contents, each contributing their expertise to unravel the chamber's mysteries. The key, once a forgotten piece of metal, had become a symbol of discovery and enlightenment. It was a reminder that history was not just a collection of dates and events, but a living, breathing entity waiting to be rediscovered and understood. As winter turned to spring, the Colosseum's secret chamber had given up many of its secrets, but David knew their work was just beginning. The items they had uncovered were not merely artifacts to be displayed in museums, they were keys to unlocking narratives that had been silent for millennia. Each scroll, each piece of pottery, each ornate jewelry piece whispered stories that challenged and enriched their understanding of the ancient world. One particularly intriguing find was a set of astronomical instruments alongside scrolls that depicted celestial maps. These suggested that Roman astronomers had a far more advanced understanding of the cosmos than previously thought. The instruments were intricately crafted, their precision speaking of a sophistication that was centuries ahead of their time. As David immersed himself in the study of these astronomical tools, he began to appreciate the depth of knowledge possessed by the Romans in various fields of science and philosophy. It dawned on him that the Roman Empire's greatness was not only in its military conquests and architectural marvels, but also in its intellectual pursuits and cultural achievements. The discovery of the chamber also raised new questions about the Colosseum's role in Roman society. It was traditionally viewed as a place for entertainment and display of power, but the chamber suggested it also served as a repository of knowledge and culture. This duality added a new dimension to the understanding of the Colosseum, painting a picture of a society that valued both the might of the gladiator and the wisdom of the scholar. David's journey with the key led him down paths he had never imagined. He found himself lecturing at universities, discussing his findings with leading historians, and even authoring papers on the artifacts they had discovered. The key had unlocked not just a physical chamber, but also the potential within David, a passion for history and discovery he never knew he had. Professor Bianchi, witnessing David's transformation, remarked how the key had not only opened a door to the past, but had also unlocked the future. It had brought together people from different parts of the world, each contributing to the tapestry of human knowledge. As the project continued, David and the team began to plan for an exhibition that would showcase the chamber's contents. They wanted to share their findings with the world, to tell the stories of the people who had lived, loved, and dreamed in the Roman Empire. The exhibition, held in the heart of Rome, was a resounding success. People from all walks of life came to witness the treasures that had been hidden beneath their feet for centuries. The items from the chamber, illuminated under the soft lights of the exhibit, spoke of a time when Rome was the center of the world. For David, the exhibit was a culmination of a journey that had begun with a simple twist of fate. The key, which he had almost dismissed as a trinket, had led him to uncover a hidden chapter of history. It had changed his life, taking him from a tourist to a guardian of history's untold stories. As the exhibit came to a close, David stood in the Colosseum once more, the key in his hand. He looked around at the ancient stones, now familiar friends, and realized that his journey was far from over. The key had opened more than just a chamber, it had opened a world of endless possibilities, a world where the past was alive and waiting to be explored. And in the heart of Rome, amidst the echoes of a bygone empire, the key continued to whisper its secrets, a timeless link between the past and those who seek to uncover its mysteries. Chapter 3. The Hidden Chamber. The discovery of the hidden chamber within the Colosseum had sparked a flurry of excitement in the academic world. David and Professor Bianchi, along with their team of historians and archaeologists, were at the forefront of this groundbreaking find. The chamber, untouched by the ravages of time, was a treasure trove of knowledge, waiting to reveal the secrets of ancient Rome. As they delved deeper into the chamber's contents, they uncovered a collection of items that were astonishing in their variety and significance. There were delicate glass vials that held remnants of substances, perhaps used in ancient Roman medicinal practices or rituals. Scrolls, some partially damaged, contained texts on philosophy, politics, and even personal correspondences between notable figures of the time. One of the most remarkable finds was a series of frescoes on the chamber walls, hidden behind a veil of dirt and cobwebs. These frescoes depicted scenes of Roman life in vivid colors, scenes of markets bustling with traders from distant lands, senators in heated debate, and the daily lives of ordinary Romans. It was a visual narrative that brought the world of ancient Rome to life. Among the relics, David found a set of metal tools and instruments, their purpose unclear at first. After careful study, they were identified as surgical tools, far more advanced than what was previously believed to have been used in ancient times. This discovery alone had the potential to rewrite chapters of medical history, showing a side of Roman innovation that was unknown. As the team cataloged and studied each artifact, the chamber began to paint a picture of a Rome that was a melting pot of cultures and ideas. It was a city where knowledge and wisdom were as valued as strength and power. The chamber, they realized, was not just a storage space, it was a repository of the empire's intellect and creativity. David, who had started this journey as an amateur historian, found himself deeply immersed in the world of ancient Rome. He spent hours with Professor Bianchi, discussing theories and interpretations of their findings. The professor, impressed by David's keen insight and dedication, became more of a mentor and collaborator than a guide. Their work, however, was not without challenges. The chamber's discovery had attracted attention from various quarters, not all of which were academic. There were those who sought to exploit the find for personal gain, treasure hunters and black market collectors who dreamt of possessing a piece of history. The threat of theft or vandalism was real and ever-present. David and the team implemented strict security measures to protect the chamber and its contents. They worked with Italian authorities to ensure the safety of the site, turning the Colosseum into a fortified research area. Despite these challenges, the team persevered, driven by the knowledge that they were part of something monumental. Each artifact, each scroll, each fragment of pottery was a piece of a historical puzzle that, when put together, revealed the complexities of an empire that had shaped the course of human history. David's days were consumed by the project. He found himself walking the line between the past and the present, his dreams often filled with images of ancient Rome, as if the city was communicating with him through the echoes of time. He would wake with a sense of having traversed the forums and marketplaces of the ancient city, the sounds of Latin and the scent of Roman streets lingering in his mind. The chamber also yielded a series of personal items that offered a poignant glimpse into the lives of individuals. A set of intricately carved bone dice, a bronze mirror still polished and reflective, a soldier's helmet with a noticeable dent, likely from a battle long forgotten. Each item told a story, a narrative of everyday life in Rome that textbooks and historical accounts could not convey. As the team worked, they documented their findings meticulously, preparing for the day when the chamber's secrets would be revealed to the world. David took on the responsibility of creating a comprehensive database of the artifacts, their descriptions, and their potential historical significance. The discovery of the chamber also led to collaborations with other institutions and historians from around the world. Experts in various fields, linguistics, art history, engineering, came to lend their expertise, each contributing to a fuller understanding of the chamber's contents. One of the most intriguing collaborations was with a team of linguists who worked on deciphering some of the more obscure texts found in the chamber. These texts were written in languages and scripts that had evolved and changed over centuries, making them a challenge to translate. The linguists' work uncovered philosophical treatises, political strategies, and even love poems, adding depth and diversity to the understanding of Roman literature. As the project progressed, David began to feel a deep connection to the ancient city and its people. He realized that Rome was not just a place of historical significance, it was a living entity that had evolved and grown over centuries, its current streets and buildings layered upon the foundations of the past. This connection was solidified when the team discovered a hidden compartment in the chamber containing a collection of personal letters. These letters, written by a Roman woman to her son, a soldier stationed in a distant province, were filled with love, worry, and everyday concerns. They provided an intimate look into the emotional life of a family separated by the vastness of the Roman Empire. As they prepared for the public unveiling of their findings, David reflected on his journey. What had started as a simple tourist visit had transformed into a profound exploration of history and humanity. He had become a custodian of Rome's past, a a bridge between the ancient world and the modern era. His discovery of the key had not just unlocked a hidden chamber, it had opened a window into the lives of those who had walked the streets of Rome thousands of years ago. The public exhibition, held in a prestigious museum in Rome, was a resounding success. The artifacts and relics were displayed in a manner that told the story of ancient Rome, from its grand political achievements to the intimate details of daily life. Interactive displays and virtual reconstructions allowed visitors to immerse themselves in the world that the chamber had revealed. David's role in the discovery made him a minor celebrity in the academic world. He was invited to speak at conferences and participate in documentaries, sharing his experience of uncovering one of Rome's greatest hidden treasures. His collaboration with Professor Bianchi had not only led to a significant historical discovery, but it also sparked a renewed interest in Roman history among the public. As the exhibition drew to a close, David realized that his journey with the key was not just about the past. It was about understanding the continuity of human experience, the threads that connect us to those who lived centuries ago. The fears, hopes, and dreams of the Romans were not so different from those of people today. In the end, David decided to donate the key to the museum, feeling that it belonged to the city of Rome and its people. The key, once lost and forgotten, had found its rightful place in the annals of history, serving as a symbol of the enduring legacy of one of the world's greatest civilizations. David returned to London, but he left a part of himself in Rome. The city, with its layers of history and mystery, had changed him. He had started his journey seeking adventure and had found a profound connection to the human story. The lost key of Rome had unlocked more than just a chamber, it had opened the door to a deeper understanding of our shared past and the timeless nature of the human spirit. And in the heart of Rome, the Colosseum stood as it had for centuries, a silent witness to the passage of time, guarding its secrets and stories, a reminder of the eternal city's place in the tapestry of human history. Chapter 4. Rome's Forgotten Treasures. The discovery of the hidden chamber within the Colosseum had become a significant event in the archaeological world, drawing attention from scholars, historians, and enthusiasts globally. David Thompson, once just a visitor to Rome, had become a central figure in one of the most remarkable historical discoveries of the century. The chamber, with its wealth of relics and manuscripts, offered a rare window into the Roman Empire's heart, shedding light on aspects of Roman life that had remained hidden for centuries. With the exhibition concluded, David, along with Professor Bianchi and the team of experts, focused on the detailed analysis and preservation of the artifacts. Each item brought with it a story, a piece of the puzzle that was ancient Rome. Among the most significant finds were the medical instruments, which suggested a level of medical knowledge far more advanced than previously thought for the time. There were also intricately designed jewelry, coins from various periods of the Roman Empire, and military decorations that hinted at the reach and organization of Rome's legions. One of the most intriguing finds was a collection of personal letters and diaries. These writings offered an intimate glimpse into the daily lives of Romans, from high-ranking officials and soldiers to ordinary citizens. The diaries were filled with details of everyday life, concerns about political changes, accounts of festivals and public events, and personal reflections that humanized the figures of ancient history. David spent months working alongside historians and experts in translating and preserving these writings. The task was meticulous and required a delicate touch, but the reward was a deeper understanding of the people who had once walked the streets of Rome. The team's work painted a picture of a vibrant, complex society where public and private life intertwined. As the project progressed, David found himself drawn to a series of scrolls that appeared to be philosophical treatises. These scrolls, written by thinkers of the time, discussed topics ranging from ethics and governance to metaphysics and the nature of the universe. The content of these scrolls challenged modern perceptions of ancient Roman philosophy, suggesting a depth and diversity of thought that was far more complex than previously known. The chamber also contained architectural plans and models of various Roman structures, including aqueducts, temples, and public baths. These plans revealed the ingenuity and foresight of Roman architects and engineers, showcasing a level of sophistication in design and construction that was revolutionary for the time. Among these plans, one particular blueprint stood out. It detailed a grand public library that, according to historical records, was never built. This discovery led to a new theory that the Romans had intended to create a center of learning and knowledge, a hub that would have further solidified Rome as the world's intellectual capital. David's involvement in the project brought him into contact with various cultural and academic institutions. He was invited to speak at conferences, participate in panel discussions, and contribute to academic journals. His firsthand account of the discovery and his subsequent work on the artifacts made him a sought-after expert on the subject. However, David remained humble and grounded, always deferring to the expertise of the historians and archaeologists on the team. He saw himself as a custodian of history, responsible for ensuring that the knowledge uncovered was shared and preserved for future generations. The impact of the discovery extended beyond academic circles. The general public, both in Rome and internationally, became captivated by the stories and artifacts emerging from the hidden chamber. Documentaries and exhibitions were created to bring the chamber's secrets to a wider audience, sparking a renewed interest in Roman history among people of all ages. In collaboration with the Italian government and cultural heritage organizations, a permanent exhibition was established in the Colosseum. This exhibition, curated by Professor Bianchi and his team, including David, showcased selected artifacts and offered interactive experiences that brought ancient Rome to life. Visitors could walk through recreations of Roman streets, interact with digital renditions of the Colosseum's games, and even experience simulations of the architectural wonders that never came to fruition. David's journey with the key led him to develop a deep bond with Rome. The city, with its layers of history and timeless beauty, had become more than just a place of discovery. It had become a second home. He decided to relocate to Rome, dedicating himself fully to the study and preservation of its ancient heritage. As he settled into his new life in Rome, David began to work on a book that would detail his experiences and the discoveries from the chamber. The book, titled The Lost Key of Rome, was a narrative of his journey from discovery to revelation, intertwined with the historical insights the chamber had provided. It became a bestseller, captivating readers with its blend of adventure, history, and personal reflection. Years passed, and David continue to be involved in various archaeological and preservation projects throughout Rome. He became a bridge between the past and the present, using his knowledge and experience to advocate for the preservation of historical sites while embracing modern methods and technologies to uncover new secrets. In his later years, David often reflected on the serendipitous moment that had changed the course of his life. The key, a small piece of metal he had almost overlooked, had unlocked not just a physical chamber, but also a path to understanding the complexities of human history and culture. As an old man, David would sometimes walk through the Colosseum, now a familiar friend, and remember the first day he stepped into its grand arena. He thought of the countless individuals who had walked its corridors over the millennia, each leaving their mark on history. The Colosseum, a symbol of Rome's enduring legacy, stood as a testament to the resilience and ingenuity of human civilization. For David, it was a reminder of the interconnectedness of time, a place where the past and present converged. In his twilight years, David established a foundation dedicated to the preservation and study of Rome's archaeological heritage. He wanted to ensure that the passion for history and discovery he had experienced would be passed on to future generations. The foundation provided grants for archaeological research, funded educational programs, and supported conservation efforts throughout the city. David's legacy was not just in the artifacts and knowledge he had helped uncover, but also in the inspiration he provided to others. He had shown that history is not a static record of the past, but a living, breathing narrative that continues to shape the present and the future. The key, once lost and buried in the sands of time, had found its purpose in unlocking the untold stories of Rome. And David, who had begun his journey as a curious tourist, had become an integral part of that story, a guardian of the legacy of one of the greatest civilizations in human history. As he often said in his lectures and writings, the key to understanding our world lies in exploring and preserving our past. The secrets of history are waiting to be discovered, holding lessons and insights that are as relevant today as they were thousands of years ago. David Thompson's name became synonymous with the Colosseum's hidden chamber, a reminder of the endless possibilities that await those who seek to explore the unknown. His story, like the key he found, served as a reminder that sometimes the greatest treasures are hidden in plain sight, waiting for someone to uncover them. And so, in the heart of Rome, the Colosseum stood, its ancient stones a silent witness to the passage of centuries, a custodian of secrets past and stories yet to be told, echoing the eternal spirit of the lost key of Rome.